Hello students, today we are going to cover another topic from fabric structure, that is modifications and extensions of sateen and satin. Already we have covered extensions of plain weave, then modifications of twill weave. Now the third basic weave, that is sateen or satin, how it can be modified or extended to produce modifications and extensions. So we will see one by one how it can be modified, means how we can produce modified sateen and sateen. So the modifications can be done by following these two steps, and very easy steps are there. First, indicate the original sateen or sateen which we are using as the base design. So you know the construction of sateen and sateen. By taking suitable counting number, we can construct sateen and satin in the required size. So whatever the size is given, accordingly we are selecting a sateen or sateen, and we are indicating the original marks of that sateen and sateen and taking them as the base marks. And then if it is sateen, subtract, or if it is sateen, then add marks, subtract or add mark, because sateen is having more marks, more warp slots. So in this case we are removing the marks, means we are subtracting one or two marks. And sateen is weft face, it is having only one cross, so we are adding the marks to convert it into modified or to modify it as required in the same relative position to each base marks. This will be clear when we will take the examples. So for this I will take four examples. One is modified sateen, second one is modified sateen in 5x5, which is known as Venetian. Another example is modified sateen in 8x8, and if the 8x8 sateen is modified, it is known as buckskin. And 8x8 sateen modified into swainstown. So we'll take four examples to understand modifications of sateen and sateen, and then we will take extensions. Extensions can be done in the similar manner as we are doing in plain weave. Extensions can be done either vertically or horizontally, or vertically and horizontally. So if we are doing vertically extension, then depending on the extension, the size will be decided. So in this case, suppose I am extending a 5 end sateen by 2 in the vertical direction. So ends will remain 5 and picks will be 10, because extending by 2. So 5x5 will be extended as 5x10. And if it is horizontally extended, then ends will become 10 and picks will remain 5. So 10x5 will be the size. And if it is extended in both the directions by 2, if 5x5 is extended in both the directions by 2, then 5 into 2, that is 10 ends per repeat and 10 picks per repeat will be required for the extended sateen or extension of sateen. The advantage of extension is that with the same number of hills, longer floats are formed on the surface of the cloth than ordinary sateens with the same number of hills, but float length of the float is increasing. So whenever we require longer floats with the same number of hills, we are going for extensions of sateen and sateen. Now we will understand first modifications of sateen and sateen. For that I am taking these four examples so that it will be clear to you how we can modify a sateen. So as I have mentioned the steps, step number one, indicate the original sateen or sateen. So I am taking first example, modified sateen in 5x5. So I have taken the size 5x5 and indicated a sateen with counting number 2. 1 and 2, 1 and 2, 1 and 2, 1 and 2. Now this is a 5 end sateen design. Now it can be modified in different ways. So first way is, suppose I am adding, because this is sateen, so we add the marks. So I am adding one mark at the right. You can add the mark at the right or left. I am adding at the right, so in the same relative position. So add mark to the right, to the each base mark. This is one modification of sateen in 5x5. You can add one more mark at the right. and it will become another variations. In this way, we can produce variations of modified sateen in 5x5. Now, second example is Venetian. As I have mentioned, Venetian is constructed on the basis of 5x5 sateen. So, how we construct sateen? Sateen is constructed just by reversing the marks of sateen. Means, if here I have indicated just by very small dots. So, if I have to construct a sateen in 5n, then this will remain blank, 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 and blank. And where the blanks are shown, in that place there will be crosses. But because we are not constructing 5n sateen, we are taking 5n sateen as the base, but we are constructing Venetian. So, Venetian is constructed by introducing one weft float on already inserted weft float. So, here are the weft floats. So, if we are constructing sateen, then marks will be indicated here. But instead of that, what we will do, we will add one more blank. So, mark will not be indicated here. Instead of this, it will be indicated here. So, three marks here. Then, this is base weft float, another weft float. So, one more weft float is added on each weft float. This is weft float. One more is added. Then marks will be indicated. This is the weft float. One more is added. This is weft float. One more is added. So, this design, which is modified on the basis of 5x5 sateen design, is known as Venetian. Similarly, buckskin can be produced in the similar manner as Venetian. Only difference is it is based on 5-end sateen. This is based on 8-end sateen. So, I have indicated already small dots for 8-end sateen. Now, we can convert it into sateen. And then we can add one more weft float, means we can subtract one mark. So, one mark is already there. This is weft float. One more weft float. And then indicate the marks. Sateen marks. Similarly, one weft float over it. And then indicate the sateen marks. Similarly, here one over it. And in the remaining, indicate the sateen marks. One more weft float is added on each weft float. Sorry, not here. This will remain blank. This will remain blank. One square just over the dot is blank. So, in sateen only one blank is there. In this buckskin there will be two blanks. One more blank over each weft float. Next is Swan's Down. It is based on sateen. So, sateen already I have indicated with counting number 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Like this I have constructed 8-end sateen in 8x8 with counting number 3 horizontally. Now, it is modified on this base. So, base is already there. Now, because this is modified sateen, and in sateen we have only one cross, so marks will be added to modify it. So, suppose I am adding here one mark to the right. If I am adding at the right, then on each base mark I will add mark. So, this is another variation of modified sateen in 8x8. I can add one more mark. This will become another variation. If I add one more mark, then another variation. But here you can see four marks and four blanks are there. And this design is reversible design. And particularly this variation is known as Swan's Down. So in this way, I have tried to explain you different variations of sateen or sateen. And these are known as modifications of sateen and sateen. Now I will take extensions. So here are the extensions. I am taking one example of 5x5 sateen. So I have already indicated 5x13 with counting number 2. Now if it is extended vertically, by 2. It means your ends, 5 ends are there. Similarly, here will be 5 ends because we are extending vertically. So one peak is extended by 2, second is 2. So we have total have 10 peaks because extension is of 2. So 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. These two peaks, group of two peaks are indicating one peak of the original setting. So here we have a cross. So this will be on both the spaces, there will be cross. And similarly, and here, then counting number 1, then counting number 1, and then this. So it means this side is only 5 equal to 5, but here 10. So these two are representing 1, these two are representing this one, these two are representing this one, these two from this, and these two are representing this one. In this way, it is vertically extended. Similarly, I have indicated brackets because we are extending horizontally by 2. So these two are representing 1. These two are representing 1, 1, 1 like this. So here, this will be indicated like this. 1 will become represent 2. And then this 2 is equal to 1. So this will be here. Then this 2. Then this 2. And this 2. So this is horizontal extension in 10 cross 5. And the last one is 10 cross 10, means extended by 2 in this direction, extended by 2 in this vertical direction, vertically and horizontally extended by 2, and because base is 5 cross 5, so 10 cross 10. And here these 4 squares will represent this one. Similarly, these 4 and these 4. Similarly, we will leave 1 and this is extension in both the directions. In this way, 13s can be extended vertically, horizontally, and in both the directions by any number. Here in this example, we have taken 2, but you can take 3, 4, whatever the number. Accordingly, sizes will change. And similarly, you can change the base design, and you can change, you can produce different variations by taking different extensions. So this is all about extensions of 13. So we have covered today modifications as well as extensions of 13 and 13, the third basic view. Thank you.